हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी श्री मुलिका देवी महाविद्यालय निगोज तालुका पारनेर डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी वाज डिस्कस रेयरिंग टेक्निक्स यूज इन मलबेरी सिल्कवर्म रेयरिंग. इन दैट वी आर स्टडीड सम इम्पॉर्टेंट आस्पेक्ट नेसेसरी ड्यूरिंग द सिल्कवर्म रेयरिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल डिसइन्फेक्शन, व्हाट इज डिसइन्फेक्शन, then procurement of quality seeds, then eggs incubation and hatching, then what is brushing and importance of brushing, then next point, that is shape and size of leaves and feeds, number of feeds of silkworm larva. Now today I will start the next important points of silkworm rearing, that is to study the methods used in silkworm rearing. In that, in previous video lecture we was already discussed the first methods used in silkworm rearing, that is self rearing methods. You know what is the self rearing methods? By using a bamboo tray in your rearing stand to transfer your young hatch new larva and to rear your silkworm inside the rearing tray. That is the rearing of silkworm in rounded bamboo rearing tray arranged on over the other in trays on the rearing stand is called as self rearing methods. You know, by using these methods you can easily accommodate 10 to 11 rearing tray and accommodate inside the rearing stand. By using this method you can easily rear the your silkworm larva in your rearing house. You know, this photo image is already discussed with you in previous video lecture. Now I think we was studied some advantages and disadvantages of self rearing methods. For example, in advantages, this method can be required limited area. You can using the self rearing methods easily rear your silkworm larva in your rearing house by using rearing tray. Some disadvantages is already discussed with you in previous lecture, that is this method required a large number of human power, that is labor. Second most important thing, that is overall cost of production is very high compared to the another methods. Now today I will discuss second very important methods of silkworm rearing, name as floor rearing methods of mulberry silkworm. In this method, the rearing of silkworm on the fixed rearing seat or branches. These branches or seat is generally 5 to 7 into 1 to 1.5 meter in size. By using these trays you can rear your mulberry silkworm in your floor of rearing house. These trays are generally made up from wooden or bamboo stool. This seat and benches is generally used for silkworm rearing. I hope you are easily understand what is the actual concept of silkworm rearing by using the floor methods. This method is financially more economical than the first one because it does not involve more labor for handling n number of trays. You know, in floor rearing methods you can directly spread your mulberry leaves in your floor. just look this diagram. You can imagine this is your floor or rearing seat. You can easily spread whatever your mulberry leaves and then put your silkworm around. Start directly rearing. So during this method, you are not required large number or more amount of human power. But if you can using self-rearing method, in this method you can require a human power for the handling of trays. But here tray is totally absent, so it is financially more suitable to the sericulturist. This method mainly used in Japan. Now next point, that is advantages of floor rearing methods. The first important advantage is, that is saving on labor expenses, reduce the cost of production. You know, if you require the large number of human power, ultimately your expenditure, that is whatever your salary paid for the labors, is totally eliminated in floor rearing method. So you can saving the labor expenses, reduce the cost of production, save the timing in feeding. You know, during the compared to the self-rearing methods, you can require a proper timing for the to remove the rearing tray and then again put inside the rearing stand to add the food material, that is mulberry leaves, inside the rearing stand. So whatever the time consumed by this process, it totally save. Second most important, that is cleaning and space. You know, by using floor rearing methods, the cleaning of floor is easily done by using floor rearing methods. And last one, that is spacing. Spacing, if you want to the culture, rear the silkworm larva inside the rearing tray, that time you are always think or always always work on the spacing, because mulberry silkworm is voracious feeder, so they continuously feed the mulberry leaves and increase their shape and size. So to provide optimum space inside the rearing tray, it is very difficult task to sericulturists. If you want to use the floor rearing methods, now here you are do not think to provide the proper space, because whole space are used silkworm for the daily activity. The cost of trays and maintenance are totally eliminated. You know, if you want to use as floor rearing methods, the tray are not required, because you can directly use the floor of rearing house. So whatever the cost and maintenance of rearing tray is totally eliminated from the floor rearing methods. More amount of worms can be reared at a time in floor rearing methods. This is very important advantages of floor rearing methods. If you want to rear silkworm larva in floor in self-rearing methods, you have some limitation regarding space, because you can just see this diagram. It is a rearing tray. So whatever the space is provided inside the rearing tray, you can use it for silkworm rearing. But if you can use floor rearing methods, in this method, you can use whole rearing house for rearing the silkworm larva. Next important point, that is, I think one point is remaining, that is growth of worms, then disease infection can be easily identified or easily observed in floor rearing method. If you can use the self-rearing method, and you want to find what is the status of silkworm growth in floor rearing, in self-rearing method, it is necessary to remove the tray from rearing stand. Then watch analysis the status of silkworm, then growth of silkworm. If any type of the disease infection is occurred in your rearing stand, you can easily observe in your floor rearing method. But if you want to find out any type of the difficulty, it is necessary to remove all the rearing tray from the rearing stand. So it will be required manpower. Second most important thing, that is, this process is time consuming. Okay, I hope you are understand what is the self rearing method and floor rearing method. Next one, that is shrewd rearing methods. It is very similar to the floor rearing methods. In this method, silkworm are reared on big branches in one or two tries. It is most economical method of all the floor rearing or another rearing methods, because if you want to culture your silkworm by using the self rearing methods, that time you require rearing stand, rearing tray. Then floor rearing methods, it is again similar to the shrewd rearing methods. Now here, shrewd rearing methods, you can just cut the biggest branches of mulberry plants, then spread on the floor of rearing house and release your silkworm eggs or silkworm young larva on particular shrewd and start the rearing of particular silkworm. The biggest shrewd harvested from the mulberry plants are fed straight to the directly to the worms. This is the main principle of shrewd rearing methods. The rearing seats are arranged 20 centimeter above from the ground. If you can use this one, that time you are always kept in your mind, your rearing seats are always above the ground level. Depending upon the space or price, can be arranged with the gap of 1 meter between the two tries. This method of rearing can be carried out in outdoor of rearing house. Now again, you can just watch this line. This is very important. If you want to rear your silkworm outside the rearing house by using shrewd rearing methods, you can easily done by using shrewd rearing methods. But when the environmental condition are favorable, especially temperature is low compared to the normal daily temperature, that is especially in winter season, you can use shrewd rearing method. By using this method, you can rear the silkworm in outdoor or outside the rearing house. The worms are supplied with a big shoot in every feed, with the larva keep moving upward consuming mulberry leaves. You know, the mulberry silkworm is a voracious feeder, so it is necessary to continuously provide a mulberry leaves in fresh condition, particularly according to age of the silkworm. For example, if your larva is young one, that is below the third instar, you are always provide the tender fresh mulberry leaves to the your larva. After the maturity, that is 4th to 5th instar, you can use some matured leaves, but this matured leaves is always provide in chopped condition to the your silkworm larva, so they are easily feed them and digest them. The rearing activity, especially cleaning, is must required in shrewd rearing method. You know, if you want to use the shrewd rearing methods, that time whatever the hygienic condition, necessary hygienic condition required in rearing house, it will be always done. For example, to remove out the unwanted excreta, then unfeed or whatever the dead debris material present in your rearing house, you are always clean or to remove out from the rearing house. So cleaning is very important, but you know, by using this method, it is little bit difficult to sericulturist to clean your floor by using shrewd rearing methods. It required only one cleaning each in fourth and fifth instar. If you want to clean the your rearing house by using shrewd rearing methods, that time it is necessary to use rope of convenient length are spread in parallel to each other lengthwise on the bed and other 2-3 feet when the worms have crawled on 2 new branches. For example, if by using the spreading or by using the shrewd rearing methods, you are always put one ropes, that is artificial ropes between the one layer of your mulberry plant branches. This rope, after the feeding or after the development of silkworm larva, you can change it by using rope. This rope is parallel to each lengthwise on the bed. By using or using some human power, you can easily transfer to the or easily remove out from the main bed. This activity is helpful for the crawling of silkworm on new branches. The bed is held by the ropes or rolled into loose bundles by cutting the ropes for every 2 meters. If you want to clean this all the matters, you can follow this method. After the cleaning, rolled bundles are spread on the rearing beds. Thus, the labor requirement for the requirements for cleaning and feeding are minimized. Otherwise, you know, it is very difficult to maintain hygienic condition during the shrewd rearing methods, because whatever your space, available space, is totally covered with mulberry plant leaves and your silkworm larva. So if any type of the excreta, then waste leaves is present inside the particular area, it is very difficult how to communicate with particular space and to clean your bed. But if you want to avoid this problem, you can use rolled bundle of ropes. By using this method, you can minimize labor requirements in shrewd rearing methods. This is the a photo image of shrewd rearing method. You can just watch all the mulberry plant branches are spread on floor of rearing house. Then you can release this one silkworm larva on directly mulberry plant branches. So if any type of the difficulty is present in this point and you are standing on here, so it is very difficult to communicate on this space. So you can use rope, and using the rope you can easily clean out. Advantages of shrewd rearing methods. Labor requirement are reduced. Labor requirement are reduced up to 50% to 60%. Then leave, that is leaves saving is about 25% and more than 25% in fourth instar and 10% in fifth instar age. Now, if this requirement, that is labor requirement, is 60% in fourth and 50% in fifth instar larva, this is the age of, well, silkworm. Provision for indoor and outdoor rearing. You know, if you want to the rear your silkworm in outdoor, that time you can using floor rearing method. It is easily possible. Three dimensional feeding reduce the leaf wastage. If you want to start the sericulture, that time you are realize what is the importance of mulberry leaves. You can easily understand this method. That is to reduce the leaf wastage. It is a very important point in sericulture because you want to continue supply the n number of mulberry leaves. So whatever the leaves wastage is reduced in your methods, it is very important. Accommodation is 50% more worms per unit area. If you can use this method, you can accommodate more than 50% worms compared to the another methods. The cleaning and feeding time is totally minimized because in this method you are, it is not necessary to clean, it is not necessary to continuous feed the mulberry leaves in your silkworm because you can directly provide whole food material at a time. So when, whatever the times you are a silkworm want to feed them, you can, they can done their feeding activity in automatically. It is not required to observe and to provide the particular food material at particular time. Rearing activity are made very easy compared to the another two methods. This method is very easy for sericulturist to performing rearing activity. I hope you are understand all the points of today's lecture. That is first method using self rearing method, second one that is floor rearing methods, and last one that is shrewd rearing methods used in silkworm rearing. If you have any problem, any difficulty regarding this point, you can ask me in comment box. Next point, that is number of feeding. You know, silkworm are feed the mulberry plant leaves, so it is necessary to count their number of feeding because if you want to the very fast development or growth of larva, it is necessary to provide quality and quantity of food material. That is, silkworm are fed to complete their daily activity or daily growth activity, it is necessary to provide the quality food material, that is quality of mulberry leaves and quantity of mulberry leaves. So for this purpose, you can preserve your mulberry leaves in your mulberry storage room. So you can easily provide mulberry plant leaves to particular time. The frequency of feeding for chalky worms depend again on the season. Generally, these worms are fed 4 times in day. So if in earlier stage of mulberry worms, that is they are forest is feeder, so they want to the large number of food material, that is 4 times per day. However, the rearing beds are kept covered with paraffin paper to for maintenance of humidity in rearing bed and to continuous provide optimum temperature inside the rearing house. So your worms consume number of feeds, or they can increase the growth and length of the silkworm larva. So it is necessary to provide a optimum feeds to your larva. The main objective of feeding are to satisfy their aptitude or their requirement of food material. Second one, that is to promote eating and digestion of leaves by larva, to keep the quality and quantity of leaves during the eating. These are the main objective of your feeding. If you can fulfill this objective, your final goal, that is to increase your cocoon production. Because you know, if you are provide a quality, quantity and proper timing feeds, you are 100% increase the cocoon production. To avoid the wastage of leaves and labor, it is necessary to always manage your feeding time and feeding quantity. For example, now here I will give the some hint regarding your feeding or feeding stage of silkworm larva. That is first feeding stage. The larva have good aptitude at the first feeding stage. Second one, sparse eating stage, moderate eating stage, then actively eating stage. Actively eating stage, they can eat voraciously during this stage. Then pre-molting stage, last feeding stage and molting stage. In here, 7, molting stage, silkworm totally stop the feeding of mulberry plant leaves. So according to their age, it is necessary to provide a quality and quantity of food material. Okay, I hope you are understand all the points of today's lecture. If you have any difficulty, any problems regarding today's lecture, you can ask me in comment box. Thank you very much to all of you.